Ophaurs can be found nearly worldwide. As they diverge from each other, they formed five distinct subspecies. First, the North American Ophaur. These Ophaurs are the most abundant, forming approximately 70% of the estimated population of 20 million Ophaurs. Their range extends as far north as southern Canada, and as far south as South America. Yeah, names can be misleading. They're the first thing people think of when they hear Ophaur. Next, the South American Ophaur. They are a different shade of brown than their North American counterparts, and about 10% smaller on average. They are faster swimmers than the North American Ophaur and spend more time in the trees. This is where they live. The Eurasian Ophaurs are the second smallest subspecies. The European population has decreased slightly because an accidental introduction of North American Ophaurs into Europe led to hybridization. The Asian population remains stable. The African Ophaur, also known as the Goldfoot Ophaur, is the second largest Ophaur subspecies. A few decades ago, they were hunted extensively for their golden fur, with people seeing it as a symbol of status. This caused large population decreases in multiple areas. Luckily, these Ophaurs were able to recover quickly. For now, they're listed as a near threatened species, but with time, they may be raised to a least concerned species. The Oceanian Ophaurs are the most recently discovered subspecies, and are the smallest. Their population is assumed to be quite low since they only live on a few islands. For now, their conservation status remains as they are deficient since there is not much known about these Ophaurs. Now that begs the question, how did Ophaurs make it all over the world? Ophaurs are a species that originated in Africa. As a result, making it into Eurasia was quite an easy task. For the other places, rafting events caused by young Ophaurs being washed out to sea on vegetation. Ophaurs rafted from Africa to South America, from Europe to North America, and they presumably made it to Oceania through Indonesia. Collectively, Ophaurs as a species are listed as least concerned with a population trend of increasing. The increasing population can be partially attributed to the decline of larger predators around the world, leading to less competition and a greater carrying capacity. Since Ophaurs never truly stopped growing, this has caused some populations to grow much larger than is expected. Usually, the upper limit for male and female Ophaurs are 80 and 105 pounds respectively. However, some areas, particularly in Africa and North America, have seen males reach 90 pounds, and some females have been reported to be 7.5 feet long and 120 pounds. There have also been reports of Ophaurs even larger than this, but they are likely just exaggerations. Hopefully. Though Ophaur populations are generally increasing, there is still one threat they face. People. The leading causes of death in Ophaurs are getting struck by cars and being shot by people who perceive them as a threat. In reality, Ophaurs are shy animals. They don't go out of their way to hurt humans. Even though Ophaurs as a species are thriving, each individual still deserves protection. And that's what you need to know about Ophaurs around the world. Subscribe for more.